I wanted to come on and just kind of do a quick my opinion on Karrueche Tran's interview with Iyanla. So I don't think I've ever heard her speak. So I really, within the first like 3 minutes of the interview, I just wanted to be like, this girl is a baby. Not that she's not a grown woman. She's a grown woman, and we're probably close in age, but you can tell that she's learning. She's young. Her youth just came through. And when I say that, that's no disrespect, no shade, no nothing. Just that, you know, she's still growing, as we all are. I'm not sure if a public interview was the right thing to do for her. I understand she's trying to clean up her image and she wants to be an actress, etc. However, I do understand that her story is not just hers. A lot of people have the same story. There are people who are riding for men who won't even give them a title, you know, and like they, you know, swear that, you know, they're always going to be there and, you know, people are mistreating them. So I feel like, of course, I am one who cuts up her name on purpose. I know it's Karrueche, or I think it's that. But sometimes I'll tell her from Karate, you know, Karate interview, her interview. So, you know, I know that, you know, we like to joke, have fun. But on a serious note, I just looked at it and I kind of felt for her. And I really, honestly, I know, you know, it's for the ratings, of course. But if I was Iyanla, I'm pretty sure after I kind of talked to her for a few minutes, I might would have turned the cameras off myself and been like, come here, baby, and just hugged her. And just, she really needs to heal off air, not here. And because, I mean, the thing about, like I said, when you put yourself out there in public, you are opening yourself. Me, as me saying I want to be more transparent this year, means I open myself for your judgment, because you don't know that much about my personal life except the part that I give you. Now, it's unfortunately when you date someone who is a celebrity in the public, now all eyes are seeing you as you are trying to grow. And if she says she met Chris, what, I think 4 or 5 years ago, and I think from what Wikipedia says, she's about 26, 21. Yeah, she was a baby. She was growing up, and that whole interview, to me, of course, Chris is the reason why she got the interview. So let's be real on that. But the issue is not Chris. The issue is her, you, me. And some people may not ever have had this issue, so you know what, good for you, kudos that you didn't go through the BS that some men can put you through, and some BS that you put yourself through. Really, Iyanla didn't get to the issue, or even, you know, chipping away at the issue till like 40 minutes in, when she asked her about her mother. And it's not about, you know, it's not always about the conversations you have with your parents. Sometimes it's what you see. What did you see growing up? What was love? What defined love in your household? What defined love when it came to your brothers, your sisters, and, you know, those people who were closest to you? Because some people can see a great example and still, you know, they still end up in a situation that they didn't ever see themselves in. And I can admit that, you know, I have been in some situations, especially when I was growing up. I came to a big city from a small, small town. My parents, you know, they've been married for like 30 years. That what I saw in my household, what I saw around friends, what I saw around people that I met, because I'm the person that loves to talk to people. I love to pick people's brain. And when doing that, I learned a lot. I've learned a lot about life and relationships in, you know, a short time, and still learning. But what really, you could tell that she's willing to go back to him. And because she said, I'll wait. You're young. This is your youth. So that's why I hope that, you know, I hope that someone watched it and realized that, you know what? I'm saying that same BS about that man. And you know what? I love him. Like I said, watch one of my, I had a video of Let That Man, Woman Go. You know, when you say, I love him, it's okay to love him. Because you know what? You want the best for people. There's people that I want the best for who just, you know, seem like life just keep kicking them. And I'm like, it's going to be okay. But at the end of the day, if they're not willing to give me, because maybe they're not ready to give it to you, but it's not your, you can be a friend without spreading your legs. You know, and I'm just being completely honest, you know, because, you know, you can still be there for someone, but when the moment it becomes exhausting, the moment where you're not happy, the moment where you're putting them before your own needs, that's when it's time to go. It, you know, you've waited for no one. You get older, you know. But it's saying, I love you, but I love myself a little bit more. So I'm gonna have to leave. And you grow. And you know what? As they say, if you know, if it's meant to be, you'll come back. If not, you know, and you may not be religious, but God has something better for you, or the universe has something better for you, for those who, you know, may not necessarily believe. But, you know, I believe that, you know, God, and I think it was one thing she said, you know, God, you know, made her, not made her go through that, but she went through that. That was, you know, part of God's plan. I agree to an extent. God will put you, may put you, send you through some mess, allow the devil to send you through some mess, but there's always an exit door. We all know, you know, there's a, not you say we all, because I know some people say they never went through this, but there has been a situation, you could just pin back to one situation where you like, how did I get here? And you had that exit. But you took the exit, and then you was like, let me go back to that door. And then you went back in. And then, you know, so it's not easy. It's life. You know, you have to grow. I just really hope that, you know, someone, she really does get therapy just to kind of, you know, get through these things. For her, I would have said she should have done, you know, kind of fell off the radar for about a year. Just kind of go through therapy. And y'all know I'm an advocate of therapy. Go through therapy, then come back with some sort of woman empowerment movement, or just came back after things had kind of settled down. Because they're still so fresh that no matter what she does, she's going to have to deal with those people who just frankly don't give a about her, you know, and that's okay, because you know, we're not, everybody in life isn't going to be your cheerleader. You have to be your own cheerleader. So she said she saw something different. She said she saw something different in him, and Yana was like, but what about how he treated you? So I think the takeaway, because I just don't feel like that was a great interview, and I'm sorry, it just wasn't, because I just feel like, yes, it was Chris Brown. Yes. So because it was Chris, I mean, that's why it became public. But it could have been Mark, Michael, Jacob, John, Joe Blow, broke Joe Blow from up the street. It could have been any of those people. And, you know, it wouldn't have been seen. So that's why it's so important to, you know, tell your friends. But if you have, if you're in a friendship with a bunch of broken friends, how can anyone really heal until one figures out, you know, man, I've been doing some stuff that I need to let go. I'm worth more. I'm worth more than this. I am worth more. And until you can get to that point, it takes time. Sometimes it takes 5-6 years. You know, I just hope that people find it in their youth. This is the perfect time to go through. I mean, because once you're 30, 35, and you're still not loving yourself, that, you know, that stuff takes a while to get up. You know, at least she's gonna be okay if she gets the right people in her circle. So, you know, I am gonna stand in my truth, and you know, we all have a past, we all have, you know, something, we all have chapters in our story that we don't want to read out loud. That is my thing. But it is those very chapters that have, that we can begin to grow from. And you don't have to announce it on a public platform, but being honest with your friends and letting them know, or some, you know, third party who is, you know, a therapist, a preacher, a minister, whoever, someone, you know, that's really, the whole thing just made me think of why I'm so, you know, doing this sending this to a public platform. And I hope that, you know, as it goes and I'm more honest in my own story, you know, I have to be willing to, you know, bear it all, but what's behind this. And of course, we all selectively put what we put out there. As a celebrity, you don't get to selectively choose what's out there. Unless you got plenty of money, you can pay people off. But definitely, that's it. So go watch my other video if you want a chance to win one of these shirts. I am strong. I picked one word that represents my life, W-Y-S. What's your story? We all have a story. We all have a story. And it's in that story that we can inspire others while inspiring ourselves. So until the next video, bye.